able to play it. And in fact, it was before Easy Hoon had even demonstrated it that he had that opportunity removed. Kindred is going to be the follow-up ban here as Bard falls for WE. Interesting. Not wanting to give that into the hands of you, but also it's hamstringing Zero just a little bit. We'll see what they decide to prioritize instead.
Yeah, that's two of Zero's supports banned away from blue side, Trundle and Bard, although yep. Zero has very large champion pool, like you said, the primary facilitator and playmaker for Team WE.
But Ryze is going to be left up. Of course, the Azir still there as well, if Punished wants to pick that one up, as the Maokai was the final ban. Amy can go towards something like the Nidalee here if he wants to. That is sort of the other S-tier jungler that is still left, but with Gragas making his way back into the meta, that is giving Amy a more of an avenue to get in there.
Big smiles for Xie, though, when the camera was back on him. Now,
oh, yeah.
Obviously looking at heart, but should expect that Xie will get his hands on that Ryze.
957, a very flexible player, could also play it. You're exactly right. A dangerous pickup here for WE. We saw it in the hands of Vici. It was awfully difficult for them to deal with, despite the fact that he did get ganked early. But Easy Hoon just happy to build Rabadon's death caps because it suited his skin. You know, running around the rift like no one was a threat.
But a pick like Ryze fits so well into the identity of Team WE. Obviously, he's just a very strong champion in the current iteration of the meta.
Yep.
But more so this idea that Team WE will take you to that single fight, that one moment, and Ryze is going to be so much more powerful than anything else LGD could be packing.
Well, Imp, if he locks in this Ezreal, will continue on his train of playing champions that he hasn't played yet in the LPL.
Will Marn match him?
Well, we'll have to see. Echo is what's already been locked in.
Could be mid lane Echo.
I hope it is, because he's already played it, Froskarin. Not going to find out just yet, as currently the Alistar has been hovered, and Imp locks away the Ezreal pick. So, bottom lane now secured for LGD. And are we having a look? Like, it looks relatively low range here on the side of LGD. They've got a lot of lockdown, though, and a lot of sort of, I guess, wombo potential in a small area.
What's terrifying, then, is that you have to get inside Ryze's threat range to
yeah.
do any damage to him. As with that Lissandra being hovered, it would mean that 957 takes Ryze up into the top lane.
Or takes Lissandra. Of course, he was a Lissandra player as well up there towards the top, so Graves is going to be locked in. Lissandra still being hovered for the moment. We'll give them a very lacking front line, and that's going to be purely on Braum to be the tanky member of the team, and WE probably looking to just run over the top of LGD before they even have a chance.
That said, it needs to be pointed out, if Team WE stay true to kind of their 45-50 minute games,
yep.
one of the teams that you don't want to take to a single team fight would be LGD, simply because they do have performers like Imp, like Marin,
oh, yeah.
who can play in those 1% of miracle plays.
And they also are on champions that are capable of doing that. Echo, of course, very slippery, very able to create big plays using his ultimate, using his parallel convergence, not to mention the fact that Imp, if he's able to play Ezreal to the level that we know he's capable of, it is a pretty ludicrous thing to witness, and you can play so aggressive whilst also being so safe with the Arcane Shift. So we'll see whether the LGD can find that in the later stages, but Victor being the current hover for Punished, and the clock is going to run down. So Victor there in the mid lane, up against the Lissandra. We saw the matchup earlier on in our second series of the night. But of course, you know, the Lissandra could be in the top lane, like I mentioned before, and that looks like where 957 wants to take it.
What this means is it really changes kill pressure around on the map. I actually... I know that 957 is an avid Lissandra player, but I actually would have rather to have Lissandra in the mid lane against the likes of Victor, just because he's going to be so much more fragile at that level 6 mark
yeah.
for Graves to come in and just 100-0 him in a single rotation of Frozen Tomb. Whereas Echo, like you said, very slippery, having the Chrono Break, much harder to punish that with.
Well, we'll see exactly what is going to go on here, because I could imagine, you know, the Ring of Frost, pretty handy in trying to at least alleviate some of that pressure, and does have a lot of wave clear at his disposal.
It comes back to the fact that Ryze will still have kill pressure. In fact, he'll probably have it a little bit earlier than Lissandra will, simply because you're using Rune Prison as your big CC as opposed to your an ultimate.
Yeah.
So I think that's the mentality here, but we should still see the same type of thing where Condi's running a carry-oriented jungler, so he's either going to be power farming or he's going to be looking to abuse the Rune Prison or the Frozen Tomb.
Well, coaches are going to shake hands. We're ready to get into game number one between WE and LGD. Thank you very much for the welcome, 957, as we are onto Summoner's Rift for our first game of our final series of the night, LGD versus WE, as we do take a look down the mid lane towards where LGD will be coming out. And look, we'll see how this one is going to start off. Of course, WE, a team known for making plays towards the later stages of the game. We'll see whether LGD can get things started a little bit earlier on. They do have the tank jungler in Amy, but definitely another ganking jungler in the Rek'Sai.
There's this thing called a 180 rule in film, and that if you're cutting, you can't turn the camera 180 degrees in between a cut simply because your audience loses perspective on which side you're standing on the camera.
Yeah.
It makes a lot of sense in chase scenes, and the reason why I bring that up is because we ended on the red side, where the red side was behind us, and then it cut to the actual end game, and
blue side
is on the bottom, and so I feel like if they just reversed it, it would be so much cleaner in intro because they broke the 180 rule.
Oh, dang it. So all of the film school students are now just really frustrated that was happening, because I was fine with it. I was just like, well, we're now back into the game.
I was like, this is a sick intro. It comes back in and blue side's underneath me. I'm like, that was
where
red
am
side.
I?
I was looking at Ryze, and now I'm looking at Punished.
We are actually going to have a look at the vote here. 65-35, so LGD actually...
That is far too
still
even.
A little bit more faith for this team, and maybe the fans know something that we don't.
The CLG of the LPL.
Yeah, there is still faith. Still faith.
But we are going to go ahead and have standard lanes. Again, priority for both of these teams, at least initially, is going to be Condi bouncing in between this Lissandra and this Ryze. He has a lot of kill pressure available. Obviously, you want to try to hit Marn as much as possible, especially because he has a power pick like that Echo.
Yeah.
But more importantly, hit Echo before he has Chrono Break available to him and becomes that much harder to kill and lock down. On the other side, Amy on Rek'Sai, let's just pray that he shows up. He's got a control-oriented jungler. He should be able to kind of find where Condi is, keep up with him. Obviously, the speed at which Rek'Sai can jungle.
Yeah.
Being increased due to the buffs to Cinderhulk. So just find the counter gank.
Well, right now, Marin has hit level 2 first. It's 957 with his Thunderlords, able to proc that, get a little bit of extra damage here. But WE well and truly in control of this bottom lane. The level 2 advantage was struck for the supports.
Not a lot Alistar can do at measly level 1. Really needs that level 2 before has the all-in potential.
Mystic just not caring at all as he just face tanks the Mystic shot and doesn't react whatsoever.
Didn't even flinch.
Yeah, that is confidence right there. As they're just going to shove this wave all the way through. And Imp is going to do probably a decent job clearing up all of those creeps underneath the turret. So nothing doing there towards the bottom side, but WE have got themselves off to a 200 gold lead. Based on that, so that's cool. Feels a bit better.
Otherwise, it's just been very quiet. LGD with their composition should probably just hope to get to the big 5v5 stage. You're looking at the 2-item power spike for Ezreal. You're looking at grouped up team fights for Victor to make the most of his Chaos Storm as well as his laser. And with a control jungle, Rek'Sai has a lot of tools to help establish vision.
Yeah.
Get around the map quickly, make sure that she can keep tabs on everyone for her team, respond with semi-global presence if she has a neural network of tunnels set up correctly, walk into graves.
Get shot in the head.
So just survive. Right now, LGD's like, this is fine, quiet, let's farm it out.
I'm also looking at WE's late game teamfight, though, and with the tools that they have in this double AP comp, as well as Condi having so much damage, I mean, just the AoE threat from this team.
It also makes it very
terrifying.
Easy to itemize against, though.
That's a very good point.
But you do then have to look towards Graves and Lucian.
Mm-hmm.
So I expect the Korean build to come out for Mystic on the Lucian, simply because he'll be able to empower the Shred and AoE spread from Graves with the Black Cleaver.
Well, Amy as well. Now, actually going to hand over a very early blue buff to Punished. Empowering the Victor as much as possible here. Even going to help slow down some of the damage. As there it is, Death Ray comes through, and that is going to be Victor picking up the blue buff. So a little bit of a advantage, but GA with the extra time in the lane was definitely able to capitalize as he heads up those CS scores.
Yeah, trying to empower Punished as much as possible. That's a very early blue buff. Naturally not as punishing on a Rek'Sai as it would be for a Graves due to her resource bar.
Yeah.
But see what he can do with it. As Teleport has been burned for Marin, not quite yet for 957. Yep. So back advantage, which is why Marin is going aggressive.
Well, 957 actually throwing out the claw for some extra damage here onto Marin. But back is going to come in here from 957 as well, who used the last remaining bits of his mana. We'll see what he decides to pick up first. I have a feeling that something like a Rod of Ages will be headed towards for this Lissandra. They're just going to start with the extra Dorans. And there's a Negatron Cloak as well. So it looks like the Abyssal Scepter. Possibly sooner.
Makes a lot of sense, facing across from so much magic damage on the side of LGD.
True.
Even mixed damage for Ezreal.
Condi actually going to come through for a very cheeky gank.
We'll see how close 957 is to level 6. He's only level 5 right now.
And Marin playing very safe at
the
moment as
well. He's very close. He's a little over halfway.
Possibly even after this wave, actually, as Condi has just vacated the area. Marin has hit level 6, though, so that Chrono Break is available. And there's a big pulverize from Yu onto Mystic, but Imp actually taking the brunt of the damage here after all of that CC had worn off. WE standing their ground in this bottom lane.
Yeah, issue is that Braum's going to throw up the wall, deny a lot of the damage that Ezreal can follow up on the CC chain. But more importantly, because Alistar put his face in it, means that he immediately takes an auto attack as well as a Winter's Bite. And then it's just a very quick 1-2 from Lucian before Concussive Blows is procced. So you definitely losing out on that trade. Does have the added advantage of having the Triumphant Roar, so some sustain available to him. But now, here we go. Lissandra is level 6. Like we said, the Chrono Break's available.
Yeah, Parallel Convergence does come down. Amy waiting patiently behind the brush. So 957 has Frozen Tomb. We'll see. If he does go overly aggressive, that could be very dangerous, and Amy doesn't want to waste time.
I think it's not necessarily that Amy wants to kill 957, but he was actually sitting there waiting because he expected Condi to show up. He was waiting for the counter gank.
Well, it wasn't to come, as Condi now finishes off his trackers, heading towards that warrior enchantment there as well, as Punished actually taking a huge round of damage from Xie here. In that window of the passive, probably a time where he probably wanted to be underneath his turret and the heck away from that rise.
So far, though, Team WE members just passively and organically winning their lanes. Yes, it's very close in this mid lane CS between Xie and Punished, but that's not where you want a rise to be.
Yeah. Imp and you, though, that's some nice damage there onto Mystic as he takes a True Shot Barrage at the same time. There's the knock up, Zero taking a bit there. As level 6 has been hit by Mystic, he does have the culling available if he can get into the position to use it. But right now, Yu hunting for another combo. And that is actually some good ground made from LGD on the bottom side of the map.
Again, it's a sustain from Yu on his Alistar kit coming in and kind of giving them the advantageous trade over the course of 3.
Yeah.
So, had the health. They've whittled down Mystic and Zero pretty significantly.
And kept up in the farm very nicely there at the same time. So, see whether one of these teams is going to want to go back relatively soon. As there's another Ring of Frost, Amy is in position one more time. Pink Ward here at the ready. It's LGD well and truly in control. And 957 is going to get knocked up. There's the claw. They don't have the CC in time to stop him from getting out.
Just the safety that Lissandra has in these side elongated lanes, especially when she's able to use Glacial Path through terrain like that, so hard to deal with when setting up ganks.
Yeah, Amy actually deciding to get the heck out of there as well as you. Is going to cop the concussive blows, but is level 6, so probably not going to get dived or anything like that. Imp making his way back into the lane, but may actually miss out on this cannon creep.
Definitely will. In fact, Yu's just sitting here picking up solo EXP, but...
did they just walk past... Oh, no, because he was stopped. That Rek'Sai was under the ground, so he just wandered past Mystic backing. Oh, it is so sad, Amy. But I can understand how it would happen. Just didn't have the vision. Chaos Storm is going to come down here in the mid lane as GA misses a couple of Qs. And he's going to take all of the damage.
I like
that
the spectator didn't sell him out.
Yeah, that was good.
He was looking at Alistair. He's like, it's okay, Amy. No one's going to see. No one will ever know.
Oh, dear.
But what I was going to comment on is this seems so small. But the fact that Yu didn't synchronize his back with Ezreal or with Rek'Sai actually means quite a bit. Yes, Alistair gets free EXP or solo EXP, but he was already level 6. So that kind of... That mark that you're trying to hit, you've already kind of achieved. And more importantly, he's not in a position where he can now group up as effectively with Amy to go and ward. Like, you don't want your support warding alone. And now this means that the Rek'Sai kind of has to wait around for Alistair to back, reset his position on the map, and then walk back towards him if they want to ward together.
Oh, 957 throws down the claw. Punish gonna get tombed up. Nice gravity field's gonna come in here as 957 has to flash, but that's gonna be first blood going to Condi as he makes his way in. Zero was over to the side as well. WE just really wanted to kill Punished.
And this is why I also think that Lissandra still has a place in the meta, is that she's one of the few champions that on these hard carry junglers, they can get a full rotation and just instantly kill someone through the frozen tomb. It's also why I thought that Lissandra would be for that mid lane, just because the kill pressure is so much easier there on Victor than it is on Echo. But again, 957, he's the more confident Lissandra player, does make his way mid lane anyway.
Just jumps right on top of Punished. So, nice play to come out from that glacial path over the wall. Marin had been given some time, though, towards the top side of the map and has actually made good use of it. 18 CS the lead now for him. Has himself some Merc Treads as well as that Spectre's Cowl. So, he's going to be pretty comfortable up against the CC-heavy 957.
And it's always going to be that question of what do you sacrifice when making a play on the map? In that case, it was the farm and experience for Marin, as Amy's now actually caught.
And Punished as well, taking a lot of damage. There's the flash forward, in fact. The exhaust comes out. Chaos Storm's going to do a lot of damage to Xie. An aggressive play that was actually counted out quite nicely with that summoner spell.
Yeah, exhaust saved his life for sure. That does mean that Mystic and Zero get to go fully aggressive on Imp and Yu, though, knowing where everyone is.
Yeah, exactly right. Yu does still have the ultimate available, as there's the ult out of Zero. They're unable to kill Imp, just Arcane shifts his way out. Xie fighting Marin here as he gets another Rune Prison out. Fair bit of damage goes in, but of course the ultimate's still available there from Marin as Condi is just going to wander over. Quick draws right into the face of the Echo. And you're right, it's just WE just organically winning every lane.
Big thing is the fact that Marin has expended TP and Lissandra and Rai still have their TPs available. They're now using this to abuse bot lane.
Yeah, here's the dive as Imp possibly going to get tombed. Not actually going to use it on you until that ultimate's worn off, and there it is. So you now taking a lot of damage, has to flash in order to get out, but WE don't find any kills. They just grab some summoners.
And that surely will mean the bottom outer tower if they choose to take it down, or they could choose to keep the lane up and continue to abuse Imp and you. The CS discrepancy between Lucian and Ezreal is really starting to take off, and there's not a super high priority to control this bottom side of the map simply because it's a Cloud Drake. But Team WE, pull the trigger, they're taking the free objective.
Yep, they'll move over, grab the extra movement speed out of combat, feel pretty good about it as Marin does have a time winder around here. But Condi, he ain't going to get outsmited, especially not when his mid lane is going to be able to take down that dragon. And Marin and Amy just sort of had to look on and watch the big dragon fall down.
Next dragon will be the Ocean Drake. We have to ask ourselves, what did Team WE give up when making a play like that? They did expend both of their TP summoners, so Marin will have a tiny window where his will be up and Lissandra's will not.
That's a good point.
They also did a good job trading the blue buff that they lost, so a small victory there. But otherwise, it's really just a small CS lead on Marin still, and big advantage to Team WE.
Yeah, Xie still looking to finish off that Rod of Ages. Does have the Catalyst sitting there. Definitely a good combination of items for a Ryze to have. Feels very comfortable. Punished. Takes away some Raptors at this point, but is still about 20 CS behind the rise as Yu actually takes a full culling from Mystic, flashes forward, picks up the solo kill, and gets himself a cheeky exhaust for his trouble.
Just straight up outplayed there. Mystic has really defined himself out of this B-rate carry role into quite an achievable AD carry in the LPL.
And not just on the Ezreal as well, which is what he was originally able to make his mark on. This Lucian looking very strong and looking like he's going towards the Essence Reaver build still. So he wants to get that late game power.
Yep, not taking a team-oriented build, even though I actually think in this situation it works
fairly
well with the Graves, but being a bit more greedy, retaining, like you said, that late game power by prioritizing crit and CDR.
Yep, 14 and a half minute Rod of Ages comes in for Jie, grabs himself some Swifties at the same time, pretty quick. Now on the Rift is the Ryze, definitely does want to be, is now the turret under well and truly fire from WE on the bottom side of the map. That will only extend their lead further. About 2,000 gold will be the lead after that tower falls, and it probably will go down after this minion wave.
But still, priority isn't necessarily on breaking the tower and opening up things for Mystic, but continuing to punish Emp and Yu, which is why we see the immediate backs come in. Team WE, they know that they could take this at any time. They've prepped it, and it will actually fall to the creep wave. So LGG deciding that they want to get out of this lane phase, but Team WE, with a play like that, they know that they're ahead. They know that they're stronger, and they're pretty much just
Yu actually going to get stunned up one more time. Does have the ultimate, but the Pulverize doesn't land onto Mystic, who turns his attention to Imp. Fantastic ultimate to predict the Arcane Flash, but Mystic able to pick that one up. Amy has turned up. It's going to be two kills, though, as Condi always at the right place at the right time. Mystic relentless pursued into that, didn't fall down, and they're able to pick up three.
Beautiful play from Team WE, and this is what we were talking about. It's this confidence. And this, who would have thought the day would come where Mystic is just styling on Imp? Yes, you have a very different support structure around you, Zero versus you, but Mystic is playing phenomenally in this 2v2.
And just completely without fear. There is no fear at all out of Mystic. He's playing beautifully the moment on this, this Lucian pickup. 2-0-2 now as well. Essence Reaver completed, now going towards something like the Static Ship or the Phantom Dancer, depending on what he wants to do. I would like to see that Duelist build with the Phantom Dancer.
But with an unlocked bottom lane, this now means that Team WE can start rotating him around with whatever build he chooses to pick and start pushing down and sieging more of these towers. So things are about to go very downhill very quickly for LGD.
Yeah, Zero actually going to turn up, finds Amy, but he is able to clear out the ward. Definitely good. Replaced immediately by Zero. GA just able to shove very, very effectively with the ultimate.
There is a sigh of relief, however, that LGD do have the victor, so
yeah,
they do have the wave clear available that at some point they can try to slow Team WE down before the snowball gets out of control.
Yeah, Marlon. Parallel Convergence is going to be able to lock down the creep wave and protect him underneath that turret as he's now going to head back to base. Mystic just continuing to push down, wants to find another outer turret for himself. As it's just the shove wars between everyone here on WE, just trying to get these waves out further and further. And with a Lissandra top lane, I mean, it's not something like an Ekko or a Maokai. She's going to be building damage. She's going to have a heck of a lot of wave clear herself.
And she's going to have a brilliant power spike at the same time that Lucian does, just because she's a mid-game champion.
Oh, the culling comes out one more time. The ultimate has to come in, but Mystic, through the ult, is still able to kill Yu.
Solo kills on the support. That's two times now that Yu has just given free power into Mystic's hands, and he's punishing his team. Dragon spawning in 1 minute. Team WE should look to quickly chip down this top tower and then rotate towards that objective.
Yeah, Imp does have his Iceborne Gauntlet, but he's not going to be able to get up towards this outer turret at all. WE will be able to take this one down, head back to base, and grab themselves a little bit more space and power with the Ocean Drake in their back pocket. Not too worried about mana, not too worried about health. Mystic is able to lock that one down, and this guy's just a one-man wrecking crew right now.
Continue to see Team WE picking him up, moving him around, now turning their eyes on the Rift Herald.
Yeah, Amy's just in the dragon pit.
Well, he knows that what he's looking for is he's waiting for Zero to walk over and to ward it, because he knows that Team WE want it. So, Amy trying to be proactive there, but
didn't quite
unlucky.
Happen. Yeah, blue buff is just going to be secured by GA, grabs it himself. more than capable of doing that as Mara now looking to try and get a gank onto the rise. Parallel Convergence is here. Marin will be able to get the stun right on the edge there as Chaos Storm goes down. Punish locks that one through. Massive CC here from 957 who wants to ult himself. Does so and gets a lot of damage through. Mystic off to the side as well. Still able to get some work done as Marin right up the front. But GA's dead. Does have teleport in 26 seconds when he will be back alive. We'll see whether they can get some work done. But LGD now want to try and get this out of turret.
Yeah, Hail Mary play from LGD right there. They go aggressive, look for the skirmish, and come out on top on a superior rotation.
Yeah, they don't want to lose this turret, though. The ultimate comes out of zero. Does get stunned by the gravity field, but does protect the tower. As True Shot Barrage gets a lot of damage onto Mystic. And GA will be up in another 2 seconds. So the rise of the teleport is going to be able to even out this numbers game very nicely for WE. I have a feeling they're not going to be able to continue this siege in the mid.
It doesn't necessarily mean a 100% free dragon, though. Yeah, okay, so LGD staggered their backs really nicely. They have a teleport on Marn, so they could feasibly contest this, but I think now they're like, do we contest the dragon? Imp and Punish, we're checking. No, we're not contesting it. They now back off.
Yeah, and GA went back and picked up a needlessly large rod and a Negatron cloak, so he had a lot of money as well when he did go home. I shudder to think of when GA is actually able to pick up, you know, some kills as well on top of this, because the man is going to be very scary to deal with. But Condi able to take down a red buff. This guy, Silent Achiever, 3-0-0 on the graves. Ahead in farm as well, as Amy actually going for the full Facilitator's build, picking up that Aegis of the Legion. And Imp now trying to pick up as much farm as he can where he can find it on the map.
He does have his Iceborne Gauntlet. He had it last fight, so not in a terrible position from this Ezreal. It's more so the fact that everyone else lost as hard as they did. And speaking of itemization, again, I don't fault Mystic for going more the traditional AD carry build, simply because Team WE historically like to fight at that really late game period where that build will take over. But it's just unfortunate that Condi on the AD Graves is also really far ahead to not have that immediate power spike from the Black Cleaver Ghostblade, and then to also empower the other 3-0 champion on your team.
Maybe Condi can just build a Black Cleaver as his fourth item or something like that after that Mora Malmortius, because of course Graves can do it as well, just can't quite stack it as fast as a Lucian. Does like the cooldown reduction though.
Oh, so does Lucian.
Yeah.
Just equates it to safety. But at this point, LGD have a 6-minute window where things should be relatively calm on the map. You can look for individual picks as Team
Speaking
W.
Speaking of which, 957 played that one out beautifully. The ultimate has to be flashed here from Marin, who's just now on the great escape. Claw of Doom comes in. 957 wants to try and lock down this Echo. In the meantime, LGD actually make use of the space that Marin is creating. He's even going to be able to get out. Nice play from this Echo as he creates enough distance in order to get themselves a turret.
Yeah, big error from Team WE. It should have just been a farm fest there for their Ryze and their Lucian to look towards that late game and to continue to keep even with LGD and then just continue to beat them around every turn. But instead, they get greedy, they tunnel in on Marn, and LGD have a really nice response. So, glimmer of hope may be dimmed.
Oh, punished. Could be in a lot of trouble here as the Chaos Storm goes down. Gravity Field not going to get any stuns as there's the exhaust, but GA just doesn't seem to be worried about it. Storm Raider Surge gives him a lot of movement speed, but eating that whole Chaos Storm is very dangerous. True Shot Barrage very close out of him.
That was actually really nice timing on the exhaust from Punish. Didn't immediately panic exhaust, waited until GA really got on top of him and was looking for second rotation of burst before tagging him with the exhaust.
Yeah, Q play. Sigh of relief now out of LGD. But GA is going to go back, see whether he finishes off the Seraph's Embrace, or at least Archangel stuff. There it is. Seraph's immediately done for the rise. So his two-item spike, well and truly in effect, and also has himself a cheeky little book. So we'll see whether he goes for something like a Void Star from here and then heads towards Guardian Angel or something like that, or whether he actually does want the Abyssal Scepter that he could be building towards right now. Makes a bit of sense when you do have 957, but I guess, you know, he's already got one. So, maybe not.
I actually would really like a Void Staff.
Yeah.
Personally,
so
Spirit Visage is, like you said, completed on Marn. Locket should be done eventually by you if he
Well,
continues.
It's actually already done by Amy.
Okay, there you go. So, Locket already online. I think Void Staff would be the right option, but I've seen some peculiar Ryze builds, as now it... Amy?
Yeah, looking for 957. Nice ward. He's going to spot him out. So Lissandra just claws back. Nice little pink ward here up towards the top side for LGD. As Condi's going to find Amy. Lots of damage here out of this Graves. Look at that. End of the line comes in, but gets into his one of his tunnels. Zero unable to follow up on too much. Well, Mystic in the mid lane setting up, as you can see.
So Team WE are trying to hold on.
Yeah, Punished in trouble once again as there's the teleport from LGD. GA has to flash, but it might be a little bit too late here as Marin has made his way in Death Race. Seraph's Embrace Shield is going to come out. But GA is running out of options right here. Does have the ultimate available. My God, almost turned it on to Punish there, but not going to find it. Does get a big summoner spell though.
And the thing is Team WE had a teleport, so they could have followed up on that, but instead choosing to continue with the play that they've been setting up, which is deep warding or their triangle vision alongside LGD's red buff and contesting for this mid and top tower.
Imp as well, keeping himself safe, protecting that turret. And WE did at least get a bit of chip damage on that inner on the top side. Imp actually coming around looking for this red buff as Condi just going to smite that one away. Nice defensive ultimate out of Zero, and they actually want to start this fight. There's the frozen tomb onto Imp, but he flashes himself to safety. Can he get the work done? 957 falls at the hands of the Ezreal already as Zero is falling down low. Death Ray going to come in. Punished grabs the kill onto the Braum, and WE positional mistake.
And it looked so good initially. The frozen tomb hit multiple members, but good response from Imp.
Yeah.
So staying true, being that all-star AD carry, and Punished also looking much better on this Victor play. So where Yu has had some issues in the early game, the AD carry and AP carry starting to compensate for LGD.
Precisely, and it's now only 1,000 gold, the difference between these two teams. Marin was able to clean up that bottom out of turret, so getting themselves back even on turrets taken this game.
Team WE have lost so much momentum that they had from the early game. So again, they were just completely dominating that bot lane through Lucian and Braum. But once they've unlocked them, LGD have done a phenomenal job on kind of two key skirmishes to either absorb a bunch of time or find picks and trade towers. And it's in these messy macro decisions that Team WE have made around the map that LGD have actually had to shore up a lot of their early game blunders.
Yeah, and also the fact that, you know, Xie was unable to help out with that last fight and sort of WE relying on all of their members working together as opposed to anything else. But Dragon is going to respawn one more time. It's going to be Ocean Drake number two here for WE. Lots of siege potential now out of this team as Condi does lock that one down. Amy a little bit late. Xie still stuck inside the pit. WE may be forced to fight this one as they're trying to throw in some poke. Parallel Convergence will be available there for Marin as he's going to make his way in. Could be a possible massive stun. Big knockups to come in here as Zero already dead. Frozen Tomb is down. Mystic able to get work done here as Amy is going to eat the culling and fall. Marin off to the back line as he uses the Chrono Break. Massive damage out of it, actually. The base is pretty high as 957 is able to lock down in before he falls. But massive triple kill out of the Ezreal and Condi. Now the last man standing. Punish grabs it. That's the ace for LGD.
LGD's team fighting looked better in their series against Vici Gaming, and it's proved here against Team WE. Great layering of CC as well as their damage abilities, particularly from Punish and Imp. Both these members are stepping up.
Just gigantic.
Thing to look for here is, of course, the big Pulverize and how it's beautifully layered with the Parallel Convergence as well. It opens up just a brilliant line of the Victor Laser, the Ezreal True Shot Barrage, as well as the Chaos Storm all overlapping.
And Marin as well, just creating so much space for his team. Made sure that Mystic, Condi, multiple people are fighting just the Echo, and LGD just steamroll through. And it looks relatively easy. The man's farming exceptionally at the same time. And look at this. Punished, topping the damage.
And this is a question that we had going into Team WE versus LGD. We know that WE love to play games late, and they love to have the confidence that they'll win that one decision late game that gives them the game. But against the likes of LGD, yes, they've had a really rough couple of splits, but you still have Imp, and you still have Marn on this roster. And if you take it to six items, do you really want to roll the dice against a world MVP and a world champion, or two world champions and a world MVP?
I certainly wouldn't, Froskron. I'm not going to lie to you. Mystic has actually finished off his Mora Malmordius here as well, so he wanted to make sure that he can survive Punished Marin and Imps damage. So yeah, no, like, look, flat out would not want to do that. As GA has actually finished the Abyssal Scepter. I don't like doubling up on that one. The passive's redundant. That's fine. If they are going to continue having these split team fights, then being able to layer that one is a little bit more difficult.
Also giving him protection.
Yeah.
Something that the Void Staff won't give you. So you're technically still getting penetration, but just minimizing it a bit to cop some defense against the like of magic damage on Echo, magic damage on Rek'Sai, magic damage on Victor, magic damage on Ezreal.
Yep. Magic damage on Alistar.
He doesn't count.
He's super powerful. That trample, man. OP. But Punished, having a fantastic game. 5-1-4. 100% kill participation for the Victor. This is a guy that we haven't looked for making these massive plays and being able to facilitate the rest of his team as effectively. And he has done so this time around. You mentioned the fact that he's having a much better game. Just want to reiterate, because it's not exactly a PowerPoint here for LGD that we're normally expecting to exist.
I'm actually higher on Punish than a lot of other analysts in the office.
Yeah?
I thought his performance on Unlimited Potential, particularly on Victor and Twisted Fate, are actually...
LGD. The trap is here. GA does have to flash out of the way. Could have gone over the wall. Decides not to. Is you just going to use the Pulverize on the ground? They get a big cooldown.
Yeah, I think Punish is actually relatively good on a limited champion pool. I think his individual performance on Unlimited Potential was pretty good. Pretty decent.
I remember liking his Kassadin a little while back.
His Twisted Fate pretty much single-handedly beat EDG when they were on their tear.
Yep, good
by
point.
Countering out the Clear Love Evelynn pick.
Like
he's
it.
A big Twisted Fate player.
They were actually hovering it for a little bit as well, deciding not to play it this time around. The Victor does seem to be the right choice, though, as he now has a Rabadon's Death Cap, perfect hex score, and as well as the Rylai's Crystal Scepter, so he's pretty happy.
I mean, the thing to understand with LGD is they had kind of just gotten themselves together last split. Trading out Acorn, taking Marn, yes, it's an upgrade, but you're still working on a new team, kind of finding their bearings together. Now you've removed the shock collar, you have a brand new support, so you're kind of back to square one. And LGD notoriously starts slow.
Yeah.
And I think there's a lot of expectations that this team was supposed to perform 2015 Worlds, didn't, but everyone keeps expecting them to be still this big elite team, and people just need to size that back down. This is a brand new team. Jungler's new, support's new, Marn only has a split underneath his belt, now working with a completely different shot caller. It's going to take them time to get it together. And
yeah.
They're facing across from a roster in Team WE that didn't make any
changes. The most
stable
in the LPL, yeah. It's a very good point. We'll see whether, you know, the WE rule is going to continue to be in effect. 3 minutes to go until their wondrous 35-minute mark. The WE do find themselves pretty pleased in. They do have complete control of these dragons as well, so that Elder Drake is going to be helping them out a little bit more. But with only oceans, only clouds, it's a different sort of story for this WE roster. Kondi still clearing things out in the jungle. This guy is close to 40 CS ahead. Mortal Reminder already completed as well for the Graves.
This is also where LGD have really thrived in these big 5v5s around the Dragon Pit. We'll see if Team WE continue to pressure into it.
Yeah, it's a Mountain Drake as well. This is a big deal. This WE do not want to lose this one without a fight. The ward goes in. Kondi trying to clear out vision where he can. Now has to try and make his way over. Gravity Field is there. Not going to be able to make it in there as the dragon does fall. And that is the most important dragon going to LGD this game. As Imp may actually be caught out of position. Bit late on the QSS, but is still going to be able to throw it down. Unbreakable not going to block the True Shot Barrage just yet. But WE still very, very healthy. Marin across the backside, but he takes a lot of damage to Culling. The full version thrown down onto the Echo as Yu is going to make his way over the top. But he's all alone. Has to flash his way back. In goes the claw. 957 is going to get in there. They grab the pick on the support, and can WE get anything more? Mystic at full health. Chaos Storm just floats by. And now GA throws down the ult, just secures this outer turret in the mid lane.
All said is done. It will be a dragon traded for a tower, mostly because Imp and Yu, again, the bot lane for LG, were kind of caught out on precarious positions. So good capitalization from Team WE to make something count, but here comes a counter TP.
Yeah, LGD actually looking for it this time around as GA getting surrounded by LGD members. 957 right in amongst it, but look at Imp getting chased down by Mystic. 957 over the top is going to be able to lock that one down. Amy takes so much damage, but GA is going to fall in the end. Condi trying to get some work done as Marin does have to use his ult to get himself out. Zero right in amongst it here as 957, another tomb comes in, and Punish is going to fall. That is massive for WE. The Claw one more time as Marin, he's trying to escape, but the CC chain's too strong. 957 grabs that kill. Zero still looking for more as Amy is going to get out, but he was the only one that wasn't dead in the last little while.
What was looking so good for LGD was simply undone by a single bad decision to follow up a counterfight on TP. It will now be a Baron, only you up and able to contest. Amy on top with Rek'Sai.
Yep, three wards over the top as well.
Level 16 smite to level 14.
Yeah, Condi actually out of this pit though. Possible smite to come in as the ultimate does come down from you. Look at the patience here out of the Rek'Sai as Amy waiting to try and get a possible steal. In he goes. This might be a little bit too early though, as a true shot barrage not going to be enough as the Baron's going to fall in. WE just ticking over 35 minutes. Welcome to the highest gold lead in the game so far.
Son of Baron comes through though. Condi secures the smite, which means that Team WE have now blown this game pretty wide open for themselves.
And look at the item buys as well. Now Bloodthirster completed from Mystic. You got a Guardian Angel onto Jie in the mid lane. That's a Mora Malmortius now completed here for Condi at the same time. He's on four items, just looking for that one more. Serrated Dirk is now completed at the same time. See what he is going to go for as his last item. If that's a last item Ghostblade, that'd be weird. Kind of like it, though.
But it was really LGD again, undoing themselves on a single poor decision on a team fight. We go back to this idea that this is still a brand new roster. They're working out the kinks. They're trying to learn, you know, what everyone's preferences are. And it could have just been an issue of miscommunication that undoes LGD in this late game where Team WE have been so stable, have been so consistent.
Yeah. Well, WE now moving towards the top side. That Baron buff needs to do some work for them. As you can see, Punished, he's trying to make sure that GA doesn't knock down his front door, or his back door, I guess. This is going to be the bottom lane.
Bottom door?
Yeah, Amy is actually going to head over the top. We do have a flash available from GA, who does use it, but maybe not in the direction he wants. Is the chase not going to happen? WE just say, all right, you can chase down our mid lane, and we're just going to take your top inhibitor turret. In goes the Claw, but 957 not going to follow it. They just need to finish off that turret. They are going to do so here as Mystic is able to lock that one down. You has to use the ultimate as Marin in there does get a stun onto Zero, but the ultimate flies through. LGD, they pick up the support. Can't get too much more as the culling is actually going to do absolutely nothing. Marin wants to find Mystic. They have had their base broken.
The issue isn't not necessarily that more resources were put to counter out Xie rather than defending the base. It was what resources were allocated where. The fact that the primary wave clear in Victor was dealing with Ryze when he should have been top.
That's a very good point. So that lead is going to extend with the falling of that turret. Only 5-3. WE still need to get some more work done with this Baron, but we'll see what they can actually do. As you're right, I mean, if Punished is actually there attending to these waves, he can do a heck of a lot of work. This is a 5-item Victor. He's looking extraordinarily strong.
Punished is massive. 6-2-4. Likewise, Imp, 5-3-4. The carries from LGD are doing wonders. It's now making sure that their tank line is communicating properly and working together to create space and opportunity for them.
Well,
or getting picked out.
Yeah, there's the Claw. Frozen Tomb's going to go down as Marin does have to use the ultimate, but he's not going the direction he wants to. Passive's there.
Lots of
movement
speed,
but Mystic is just probably going to get this kill delivered to him. Nice work. Picks that one up, and it's relatively easy.
Condi, hello? Through his ultimate?
Well, you know, that's what Condi does. Secures kills by, throwing down his ult. That being said, it is going to be a pick-off. We'll see whether anything else is going to come of it. 8-1-7 now for Mystic. Only missing out on one kill participation in this whole game. And they are going to be able to translate this into the inner turret. Without their tank, they can't really get much done. Yu does have his Unbreakable Will available one more time.
Punish is in position, though.
Yeah, exactly. Well, Gravity Field goes down. Bit of chip damage on this inhibitor turret.
It's a good thing that they do have a cannon wave, so continuing to poke at that, although there
cannon
it goes.
Just wore off. WE now moving back. Turret falls in the mid lane, though, as 957 getting some good work done offside.
This is going to be really dangerous. Marn is up in 7 seconds. Yeah, okay. This is a good call. So Team WE don't want to overextend, don't want to overstay their welcome. Really respecting Marn's death timer. As I say that, they're setting up a trap.
Yeah, they were. But Preyseeker is going to find them. They were moving around a little bit too much, I think, with the entrance of Amy. And now, yeah, the little splooches are going to be enough to make the work done. But GA looking for a home guard teleport here.
If they fight this Elder Dragon, they're sitting on a lot of individual gold. They just took down two global structures.
Yeah.
So this is actually just really poor back management from Team WE. It gives LGD at least not the opportunity to take the Elder Dragon just because it takes a long time to kill it, but to at least move into the area and start setting up vision. As I say that, LGD are like, we see your terrible backs and we raise you. Also terrible stack.
That was their play. That's the maneuver. We will also just back badly. That is Lord Dominic's regard, though, completed here for Mystic. He's got six items. Six items as well for GA as the Void Staff was picked up. Decent power play there. It's 4.5k.
Yeah, they got a ton out of it. They executed with the Baron wonderfully. It was literally just the back half of it that was mismanaged, as we're now going to contest the Elder Drake. Again, this is a very big monster.
Yeah, immediate ultimate here from you. And even with that, we'll still fall down as WE have already got the pick, and that is so much of the CC needed in this chain. Now dead. Amy trying to find his way in tunnels through, but it's just going to take a lot of damage. Really nice Chaos Storm there, but 957 is going to be able to lock down Amy. Punished now as well, struggling in the face of 957, who has to flash out of the way. Zero, not dead somehow. Not entirely sure how. That is going to be a 2-for-nothing in favor of WE.
And WE's gold disparity is speaking for itself. Not only were they able to fight LGD and pick up some kills, but they were also able to fight the Elder Dragon. So.
Oh my god, there's the flash forward. Imp in trouble. Mystic locks down the kill. Now it's dancing away from Marin where he can. And that Bloodthirster is doing so much work. Marin has to now escape as GA gets exhausted. Now his damage is going to be right out in front of him as Punished is running away. Decent gravity field is going to knock him back. That is a big knockback as Yu is going to headbutt him out of the way as well. But this could be the base broken open and the first inhibitor of the game falling down for WE.
With Punish blinking red, the wave clear isn't available for them, so it will be possibly two inhibitors as a lot of pings are going towards the top side of the map. Reminder, Team WE are sitting on so much gold still. After they make this back, if they don't end it here, they'll be unstoppable.
Yeah, Frozen Tomb comes out. Marin just eats it, though, like a boss. Not worried about that damage at all. Does have a fountain available to him. They haven't taken down the top inhibitor, though. There were minions crashing onto it, but bottom lane inhibitor is the one that they want. His Baron's up in another 24 seconds, and they'll have super creeps helping them with that one.
Just
but six items for everyone. This is just crazy. Condi,
it's just
4-1
the
and
top
10.
Laner.
Yeah. But even on the side of LGD, we're getting to the point where gold's becoming irrelevant. And it is an 11,000 gold lead, most definitely for WE, but, you know, some stages, that doesn't matter. Everyone's given 150,000 gold. Literally makes no difference.
It's just the race to six items. Unfortunately for LGD, they've lost complete control of the map simply because an inhib or the Baron inhib is down, as well as their top inhib is exposed. WE have their pick of the litter, and this is exactly where they like to be in all of their games. We call WE kind of the card counters of the LPL. They sit and they play the long game, and they just watch you until you make that one single mistake. They only beat you once, and they hit you hard.
They most certainly do. And now, Super Creeps having to be dealt with here by LGD is punished way back in base. And the Baron is available. Amy is hanging out in the area, just using that Tremor Sense to make sure she knows what's going on, is the Rek'Sai. Imp waiting for that one more item. Punished, completely done with his build. This guy is massive. Morellonomicon actually completed here. Smokescreen going to come down. Condi, they know exactly where he is. Just patrolling around the Baron. Has actually been started. They don't have anyone who can really tank it all that well on the side of WE.
But they do have a very different strength of smite, level 18 to level 16.
Yeah, and an Ocean Drake, meaning that they can start it up and then just get heaps of regen. But here could be the fight. Big ultimate out of Zero, actually setting things up quite nicely here now as Marin putting himself around the side. True Shot Barrage locks down Condi for a lot of damage, but Amy's just going to get obliterated. Not on the same page here with LGD is the Rek'Sai. And just throws himself in when they weren't ready to commit.
LGD unfortunately have a very small window. They have about one more wave to kind of contest this before their Nexus Tower will be under threat. Without their jungler, they have to fight.
Yeah, and look at this. The Baron is going to fall down. LGD is going to make their way in. Condi locks down the Baron, though, and look at the Frozen Tomb out of 957. Heaps of work done as he's able to kill the support at the same time. GA takes down Punished, and now LGD just on the run. I mean, 957, just teleport into the base, man. You can finish this game.
I think that's exactly what he's going to do, resetting his position on the map, and there he goes.
Yeah, there's the teleport, so right on top of a minion. Already one Nexus turret is going to fall down. Look at all that wave clear available here for 957. Azir is going to get taken down by Imp, but Mystic is so big. It's just scary out of this Lucian. And now Marin fighting Super Creeps, fighting WE. Condi here as well. It seems to be fighting everyone, but the Nexus will eventually fall down. WE in the end. It's a very solid performance, but once again, LGD actually able to fight back through most of the early and mid game.
But do not be fooled by a late game against Team WE. This is where they like to put themselves, and they consciously do it every single time.
Yeah, they most certainly do. And look, I think a lot of this has to do with the fact that, I mean, LGD played well in where they're strong, but you getting caught out multiple times in that early game made Mystic this completely bogus dominating force on the Lucian. It was just too scary to deal with.
LGD had, I think, two good team fights as well as one initial good pick on that mid lane. So again, great individual performances from some of their members. I want to highlight Imp, Marn, and Punished in particular. But like you said, unfortunately, Amy and you were just too much fodder for Mystic.
And look at Mystic. Picks up the kill and now straight in there on top of Amy, who could have just turned around and auto-attacked him and he would have died. But man was confident in his team. As this is the fight that LGD were able to, send WE skyrocketing. Glad that we have this particular perspective for that one, because they went pretty high into the air.
They're breaking the 180 camera rule.
Oh, damn right. We're breaking all that. This is the 360 camera rule now.
It's fine, because they're not making any cuts. No, but what this team fight proves is that LGD have the tools. They can get everything going, but to consistently do it, that's the issue. It's the consistency.
Yeah.
And I just want to reemphasize this. A lot of new players on the roster, still building synergy. LGD historically start slow.
Certainly do.
It's now a question of development. You know, what does this ceiling of this iteration of LGD look like? You go across, you say, okay, Punished, probably not as good as Wayless. You, probably not as good as PYL, so it's not going to be to the height of the 2015 summer playoff LGD. But they don't necessarily have to reach that high.
Yeah.
Just hit the bar.
And we'll see whether they can actually do it. Of course, they still do have one more game, ladies and gentlemen. We are going to throw to a short break. When we get back, we'll see whether LGD can reach that ceiling and come up with a victory in this best of three.